Teen Empires, turn to ban. Radiant team ban.
And with that, folks, we're into game two. We've got Team Empire versus Team Alternate for the Starladder I-League Series 13. And as we mentioned, Empire is up one game now, but they are probably already out of their group. So if they can take out Alternate here, they are pushing them out of Starladder. So let's hop right into the draft, folks. And once again, I'm going to be Llama Down Under. I am joined by PQMZ, who will say hello as he's unmuted. How you doing?
Team Empires, turn to ban.
Yeah.
Radiant team pick.
Also, I forgot to mention, we have Mac underscore Dota, that's his name on Twitter, doing stats with us. So let's get into it. Team Alternate, I don't feel like they played that game poorly. There were just a few bad team fights and Empire snowballed from there.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, 100%. So instead, we're going to be seeing the Slaughter for Team Alternate. Always a powerful pickup, but Empire get Tusk and Wyvern, and Wyvern blocks out literally every damage source the Slaughter has. So fun. Yeah, no, it's a great hero, right? I was just having a bit of go at the whole, like, Wyvern is arguably a pretty hard counter to the Slaughter. But of course, there are other heroes in the game, so. Yep.
10 seconds remaining.
So, 100%, we've got the Bane, always a popular pick. Had some success last game, but I feel like once Team Empire got their business together, they were on point on canceling those ults. And also, it just feels like when you pick the Bane early, of course, always a good hero for that Fiend's Grip, but a lot of people were stopping the Fiend's Grip right when it came out. Oh. Yeah, it's no good when someone steals your Fiend's Grip. Ugh. But gonna be
Radiant team.
Gonna be the Windrunner and a ban out. Do you think Team Alternate will bother getting rid of the Rubick, or is this just the price you pay going into Empire, saying that might be picked against you?
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like already just with all of Bane's toolkit, your Rubick's pretty happy. So, yeah. Slithering and Crush, of course, a bit harder for the Rubick to get off just because you don't have a positioning tool like Sprint, but we saw Aloha Dance, no form, zero to hero, I would argue, is what he did, because he had no form, and then suddenly he's like, by the way, guys, I have a blink and an axe, okay? So if you could all please just calm down. So, that was good. We've got the Wraith King ban out again. They do not like silence Wraith King, which I think is just kind of funny. He's not a hero I think of as ban-worthy.
Team Empire's turn to pick.
Yeah. So, all good things. It pretty sucks when you use... It's similar to when you have to be a doom dealing with a Wraith King. You don't want to use your big one team fight spell that then gets completely negated because the person respawns. But we got a Phantom Lancer and Team Empire. The game that they lost to CIS Rejects, Silent was top of the net worth chart for most of that game and then couldn't manage to seal the deal.
Ten seconds remaining.
Yeah.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
So, Templar Assassin being banned out. I won't deny that she's a good hero, and they go with the Invoker again. But I guess they're worried on Empire about the minus armor strat, which makes a lot of sense. Even though they have someone like the Wyvern, because of course, Psyblades are pure damage. Now, Invoker again. I feel like this is really painful for the Wyvern, just because you're kind of prime target for an Invoker.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah, we've been seeing a lot of Blink 4-star Slaughters, but I do agree, we've got kind of a weird build where Slaughter, of course, wants to amplify your right kick damage, most famously paired up with the Windrunner this patch. And we got a Gyro, who doesn't really get online with right-clicking for quite a while. I think we've already seen that Supreme prefers the Quas Exhort Invoker. Not Exhort, sorry, Quas Wex Invoker. There goes my brain. As opposed to the Exhort, which I think you can build a bit more right-clickery. Clickerish, thank you.
Radiant,
you know what I mean though, like, you build for more right-click damage, I believe would be the appropriate way to say that, but I was really hoping we could turn it into one word. So, yeah, A banned out. Now, I don't know if this means that this is going to be an offlane Queen of Pain and that we're actually going to see an Alk or a Husker be picked up by Empire. It could just be the AA ban out because that's a really nice counter to the Wyvern. You cold embrace someone and then they take a blast to the face. So, what are your thoughts?
Reserve time.
Yeah, I agree. So, Empire getting rid of that hero, and now Team Alternate, they get to decide on what they want to get rid of. I think they're probably worried about something like the Alk here, just because, sometimes you get to worry. Although, I would be much more worried about the Husker than the Alk. Of course, Husker having that Berserker's blood, meaning that he doesn't take as much magic damage, which you have a lot of, but then Slaughter deals with him. So they just ban out the Rubick. They don't want to deal with the Aloha Dance this time.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Yeah.
10 seconds remaining.
I agree. Oh, and it's that one that you mentioned. We got the Night Stalker going to be seeing some Cripple and Fear action. So Team Empire, they have, I think, a really nice draft for making space for the Phantom Lancer. Queen of Pain, Night Stalker, Tusk, all heroes who can just roam around the map being a real pain, while the Wyvern can make sure that the Phantom Lancer isn't having anything too bad happen in his lane if she needs.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Spirit breaker. And it's a spirit breaker. Vision game, eh? Spirit Breaker is also really nice against a Phantom Lancer and a Quap because he keeps vision on them despite their mobility. Even if you Doppel, the Spirit Breaker is still charging the real Phantom Lancer, and with Queen of Pain, you see her in lane, you know maybe she's going to farm the jungle or move somewhere else, and you have her being charged and you have a line of sight. So we'll see what they can make of that. So with that, let's get into game two. When people pick their heroes or the timer counts down, we'll be loading in. Looking at these two teams, I have to say I'm a big fan of Team Empire's lineup. I really feel like Phantom Lancer can bring a lot of hurt to the Gyrocopter. A lot of people think Gyro is a counter to Phantom, but you only have 6 shots of Flat Cannon every 30 seconds. Phantom Lancer is going to replicate more illusions than that, I think. And he's not going to be terribly worried.
Biggest difference in the matchup is just, if you're equal on Farmers for Gyro, you're behind. Top of that, the rest of his team has to help him out with the PL. If the Tornado, whatever combo, fighting what he goes for, it could either be the Meteor, etc., if it actually lands, really hurt the PL. And I can speak English.
Yeah, it'd be really weird if you could speak English, being British and all. I would.
I'm just stumbling over myself like an idiot today.
We've actually been casting some in the interim, but as most folks know, most tournaments have been a bit on hold with the majors happening, so we've got to get folks all warmed up again. This is some fun zooming action. We are paused, as most games tend to be. Let's give the players an introduction, just because with a Tusk, we sometimes see some first bloody excellence. That is not English for that either. We're setting horrible examples. At least our stats man, Mac Dota, has his stuff together. Look at this. He actually has it together, unlike the rest of us. Let's get it together, PQ. We've got Resolution on that Queen of Pain. We got Flow on that Tusk. No Fear on that Wyvern. Silent on the Phantom Lancer. And finally, Nightstalker on... Yes, Nightstalker on top of Aloha Dance. That's how we're going to say that one. Tossing it over to you to introduce alternate while I drink my tea.
Got Nisha on the Slaughter, Robert G the stand-in on a hero that is yet to be determined. Guessing it's Vayne. And
yeah,
they have
the
Exotic Deer on the Gyro. Supreme on the Invoker yet again. And Elisash. I'm horribly,
I'm sorry. I call him L.
Yeah, I'm down with that. L on a hero that is yet to be determined. I'm an idiot and forgot half their draft. They had Vayne on one, and the other support was... Help me out here.
No, because then you'll know my secret. No, it was the Spirit Breaker. So I think that's going to be L's hero, just because Vayne last time was on Robert, the stand-in, who may or may not actually be a stand-in. I don't know how many of you folks know the fun details of how this works, but basically the tags, when you enter a ticketed game, if you're on the team, who paused? Okay, they have 10 minutes. Yeah, they have a 10-minute pause. I'm not quite sure what's going on. I believe...
Guessing Leo wants the pause, and then question mark, question mark.
Players. Yeah, I'm also guessing that ATN is kind of like, really, you're going to give us some crap when we waited like an hour for the previous game, but that is neither here nor there. That is a life choice to make your effigy title, No Fear.
One, I didn't even see there's any effigies.
Oh yeah. They don't appear until the players load in, so the Radiant may actually have a few. The models are still having problems, as we can see by Legion Commander's armor being literally, Show me your stuff, ranged barracks. I'm just having a look around at the effigies while we wait, so... Christy! Probably someone important to Flow. I mean, it's not... I am pretty more bad. In favor of fixing actual game-breaking bugs, and...
I have different teams for that stuff. There's like...
No, they don't.
Teams that actually balance the game, and then there's fix bugs. And the teams that fix bugs, and they will fix Roshan bugs, and they will fix Spirit Lance bugs.
So, they're most likely are the same devs, someone who's worked in software development. Like, I really doubt it's different people, and it's usually the small bugs, you just, like, file them away. It's like, and the worst part
is, okay,
they're
not small bugs,
No, let me tell you the worst part about working in software development. Sometimes there's a bug, and it's, like, not in your area at all, but then your manager comes in, and they're like, yo, Llama, can you, I see you finished your work, and you're all like, yeah, pat on my back, and they're like, finished your work, so you want to go take those bugs you know nothing about, and you're like, no, I d- aw, shucks. So, long story short, get your work done when you say it will not beforehand, or you get punished with more work. But let's talk about this game, because we finally have people loading in. Who are you favoring, team-wise?
Empire's Dragon is slightly more easy to execute, just on the fact that they have more mobile cores, and they can do more with their supports. I'd favor them for that reason, but if ATN get off to a good start, they definitely have the potential to do a similar thing to last game. If they can just execute slightly more cleanly, it's not a huge difference in drafts, I feel like.
Yeah, I think, as you mentioned, a lot of it's going to come down to the execution, and of course, this is where people are going to be favoring Empire. They are the more experienced team. They've played a lot more games. L is like, look, we hate our gyrocopter. We were so sorry for his actions. Mango instead of Mouse. What? Mango instead of Mouse. He does have a mango on him. I don't think that's particularly a bad item pick up for a gyrocopter.
Maybe he has a mango and
so I was thinking that, which like I would argue isn't a problem. I mean, I guess it's a problem for playing Dota, but mangoes are delicious.
Maybe he's eating a mango instead of playing Dota, and that's the problem.
Yeah. He could also be eating a mango, and as most people know, good mangoes, they make a mess everywhere, and his keyboard could be entirely sticky now from that mango, and he can't play Dota because the keys are all stuck together.
Yeah, it's a big problem. Getting a game is hard. Like, try and eat, and then stuff gets all over your keyboard, and your mouse gets sticky. I never eat pizza while I'm playing.
I used to eat everything with chopsticks when I would eat, because then I can, like, eat the food with chopsticks, just, like, put the chopsticks down, go back to gaming. Yeah. I would eat chips with chopsticks in uni at LAN parties, and people would give me such dirty looks, and I'm like, which one of us doesn't have Cheeto dust on our keyboards,
If only I could use chopsticks, that would be a brilliant... but there's a flaw.
Swaffle, let's get into it. Okay, we finally maybe got a game. I bet you there'll be at least two more pauses this game. I don't actually want to make that bet because I probably just jinxed us to actually have, like, horrible things happen. So I didn't say that, folks. We're getting into it. It looks like we're going to be having Resolution run down that mid lane. Quap versus Invoker. This sucks for Invoker. Like, I tried to say it politely last time, but Invoker, he really just has a hard time in lane. He doesn't start with much damage. He has, maybe if your opponent's really out of position, you can get a kill, but Quap's even harder than a Shadow Fiend to get a potential kill on.
I don't know how he got the kills on the Shadow Fiend, or at least the first one, but it worked. Quap, he can get kills. Cold Snap can constantly
30 blink, seconds to battle.
And the mana pool might not be the highest, so she could possibly drop to below 60. I think the biggest thing this game is, one, the ward that Empire already have out is going to help with the Qual out with the high ground vision. Seeing where the Invoker moves helps a lot. Top of that, if ATN have the Bane come in, it could be really volatile early game, and that might help Invoker out a tiny bit.
Speaking of volatile early game flow, he is running right at them, taking almost a full rocket barrage. He has ice shields, there's going to be no snowball action. Robert, I think he tried to go for the charge, but instead it is L taking huge amounts of damage. There's going to be a charge over to the side, they're doing a lot onto Weapon X, and L, he turns around, he has Brain Sap in 4, but if two more auto attacks should kill him, and that is our first blood. Exotic should get the full rocket barrage, no creeps to deny yourself to, Aloha Dance, and that's going to be at the end of that skirmish, folks.
So. Empire definitely winning that with Quap getting the bounty rune. Yeah. Glad I got the one top, that's not as big a deal. It's not the mid advantage, fully cemented.
So.
First blood's also pretty nice for Nightstalker, getting halfway to an urn, maybe.
Yeah. So a really nice play coming out on the Supreme is going to, again, be going Quas Wex.
Ori is dead, I think, in 5 seconds.
Oh. Yes, yeah, now this is something dead. That's really common. Wyverns have been doing this. Will he even pop? Oh. Yeah, I was a bit worried he might not have the damage without... Oh, she might not have the damage without the Winter Wyvern. Yeah. A lot of Wyverns, they do the Octic Bone action. And while L is trying to make sure that Invoker is winning this middle lane, doing a lot of damage to Resolution, losing your Courier, devastating. The Walking Courier, I think, like, 150 bounty each way, or maybe that's the Flying that is 150. But it's huge. It's a lot of gold for your entire team.
They already have like a 700
gold lead. And
on
L is dead.
They're getting a kill.
Yeah, so... but can they get the return kill onto Nofia? The auto attacks, they're just not doing enough. He needs two more. Oh, he gets it. Nofia is going down. Wasn't level 2 yet. No points in that cold embrace. Although Quap, she's going to blink forwards. Is there going to be a screen? She just has Shadow Strike. Can they? Oh, he needs the deny. Isn't able to get it. This mid lane is a bit of the Motor Zone, I like to call it. The Motor Zone Thunderdome. And I think that's finally going to stop. Quap actually greedily going for Lost Hits. She may take a Brain Sap here and go down. I think she's dead. Oh gosh, my mouse stopped working for a second there. Oh my gosh. That was actually terrifying. And I might need to redo my configs in a second. But yeah, I thought I was going to miss that. He's going in for it again. He wants the Nightmare. But no fears here. And this is dual mid action.
Yeah, and I think the Bane is going to have trouble again. The Quap's going to blink forward.
They use the Nightmare onto one. He should be able to pick up the Bounty Rune, but I think he does tick out here. Quap, of course, 15 second cooldown on that blink. Actually gonna let the Bane go. Nofia maybe thinking about following. But we got two supports in this mid lane area. I mean, Nofia's still level 1. I think that's the big difference between these two supports for me. And Bane denies himself as Nisha falls in the top lane, and Nofia is very happy to be a part of this considering his status in the game.
I should have actually been able to get that kill on the Bane, but the Wyvern took, like, it felt 10 years to take the sleep off of Quap, so maybe Smells or something, couldn't get the right click in time, but Bane eyeing himself, doing the efficient thing, getting back to base ASAP.
So, now, we haven't had much time to talk about the other lanes just because there's been so much action in middle and there's about to be more because Aloha Dance is stalking Supreme, but in top lane, we have Nisha on the Slaughter. Doing Slaughter things. He, of course, has already taken a tumble, and we can see that Silent is lost, hitting not as well as the Gyro, but he's doing pretty dang well.
Yeah, I think the factor at the moment is that there's a 3-minute phase boot, Night Stalker. This pretty much means if you're away from your towers, you're in trouble. He's gonna run at you and hit you really hard.
He also is already level 3, he's coming in, it looks like L is going to be the one going down again. Resolution doesn't have an aggressive blink up, 15 second cooldowns on that one, but there is the Void, and oh, Aloha Dance, he was thinking about diving that tower. The Courier's finally back up, so he's getting stuff, and Gyro down bottom, Exotic Deer, he played this last time, he played it well, but again, we're not sure if it'll be enough.
I think it's like, just managed to get ahead, then it's good. But that's a lot easier said than done. Invoker's gonna have to make a lot of space this game, which is gonna be really hard because despite the fact he's winning in CS mid, he's even with the Quap. But so many heroes that can trouble this game, he's not gonna feel really confident. So it's
also
up to the Slaughter to enable him as well.
The Invoker is destroying the Quap on CS, but of course she has some of that kill involvement that he does not have as much of. So, Nightstalker, it is his first night time. He's only level 3, which is generally fine for a support Nightstalker, but he's really far ahead, as we talked about with those phase boots. And Robert, no fear, running up to the Nightstalker. I would not try to trade with a Nightstalker at night time. Yeah, the Gyrocopter's coming, but I think Nightstalker's gonna walk away from your damage, even though you have that Orb of Venom, Robert. But oh, he manages to use the charge. There comes the Rocket Barrage. Aloha Dawn's taking quite a bit of damage. They don't have the follow-up though, and now with the Orb of Venom wearing off, they need to get on out of there. Quap is also only level 4. Snowball onto Exotic Deer. Rocket Barrage should be able to come out. They've trapped him off, but a Nightmare comes out, so now no longer taking a lot of damage. Resolution pops it off using the Scream, and now Exotic Deer probably gonna fall, but can they get enough damage to catch up Flow? They can. Not a worthwhile trade, unfortunately, I think, for Alternate.
Big lack of 17% coming out from the stand-in there. Disappointing show from him.
Clearly doesn't practice.
I think the Nightstalker died there if they got one bash at the right time. So that was risky from him.
So, Silent gonna be just chillaxing up top. Now, something I want to mention, because of all these rotations by Empire, he hadn't been having, you know, initially he was up against the Slaughter. He was a little bit lower CS than the Gyro. I'm not 100% sure what was causing that. But now because they're putting pressure elsewhere and Slaughter has to be worried because the supports are off the map, I think Silent's pretty free to farm, although as I say that, he's being charged.
But it's really hard to actually lock him down because he needs him or sleep him before charge connects.
Now they're going to use the charge. If they time it well with the Slithering Crush, they might have enough lockdown, and they do. They manage to pick up Silent, and at the same time, Resolution, he goes down on that Queen of Pain, but Supreme, I think, going to pay with his life. He's trying to walk away, but two more auto attacks and the Ice Shards, making sure that he's dead. Flying through his dead body, I think, there.
Yeah, and that's definitely good for ATN. They lose their Invoker, but the two cores of Empire getting put slightly further behind. As you said earlier, Resolution, despite his kill involvement, his CS is awful.
I think just because he's had to be so mobile, he's actually now fifth on the net worth chart, so not doing so great. At one point, he was the top. But yeah, he's 10-7. It's not great, but he's been blinking around a lot, getting kills all over the place, and unfortunately, it looks like it's now not paying off with Supreme getting the return kills, but it was for a while there. Definitely doing good work.
Yeah, it's really hard when, like, the mid lane's so brass heavy. You have two supports, a false support on either side, and obviously both cores, and you're just hitting each other again and again.
Oh my goodness, it's gonna be the Ambien, as you said! They'd managed to stop some of the blinks, but not quite enough. Tornado damage.
Can't believe he got out.
I think if the EMP hits, he's just dead there, right?
Yeah, I'm actually really surprised he could get the blink off between the cold snap intervals. Maybe he needs level 3 cores before.
Yeah.
Happens to the cool reduced
100%. So, gonna see what Invoker can do. He's also got the Super Saiyan Invoker, so that adds to your power. 100%. We've got a charge coming in onto Resolution. They have another Cold Snap at the ready and the Tornado. This should be enough damage. They managed to get the clean Quap kill. TP's coming in from Aloha Dance, not gonna do anything.
Really surprised he didn't blink there. I guess he was looking somewhere else on the map, maybe looking at the chicken where it is. Why supports are hogging. I don't know. But that's a really good kill.
I thought you said hugging the chicken? Like hugging? And I was like,
I mean, would you hug the donkey?
I would hug an actual chicken. I've hugged a chicken before. They're incredibly soft. Nighttime has been popped, and I am not sure why, but I think it might have to do with poor Nisha up here, who's going to be taking a Splinter Blast, a whole bunch of Octifern, manages to get the stun out on Silent, but he has a spear for you, and sprinting through the Wyvern, it's not enough! Oh. This is the power of Slaughter, that hero. Do you think he's receiving enough when the patch drops mid-December?
I mean, the question is he? I think it's how severe is it?
Mm. They could just change back the sprint a little bit, because it did get increased uptime that I feel had a bit of an impact, and, you know, maybe reverting that. But not important. We're gonna have an EMP. I don't know if this will drain all of it. It looks like it does, and Resolution is deadzo, is the technical term. So a nice kill there. And they even committed the charge. I have to say I'm really impressed with the rotations from both team. I feel like the Bane, Spirit Breaker, Nightstalker, and Wyvern all have been rotating really nicely this game.
Yeah, this is typical Russian Dota. The supports are constantly moving between lanes, making as many kills happen as possible. One or two lucky runes here or there, making things happen that wouldn't. There's a lot of stuff going on. And I think that favors ATN right now, just because a really strong fighting hero early. He has face drums at 9 minutes on top of a stick and a null. Sorry, a wand. That's really, really good. And Quap, like, she can't fight into him. She's level 5 when Invoker's level 8. Just about to hit level 6.
Having a look around, we can see the golden experience is pretty even, all things considered. And I also just wanted to do, as you said, a quick item roundup. We got boots being rocked by almost everyone in this game, not one of those sad Dazzle games like we saw earlier today. Aquila apiece, and Urn almost done on Robert Standin, sir. And as I say that, we have a cooldown. We have Exotic Deer taking a lot of damage, but the cooldown, oh, the Splinter Blast ends up finishing him off. Is Flo just gonna survive this? Where's the TP rotations coming out from Alternate? There's nothing. Robert is going to go down before they can even get the Bane in, and even if he nightmares someone, I think that could have been leading to Bane's death. So L gonna be able to walk away, but losing two, including their core. I thought for sure they'd be able to catch Flo there, but Cold Embrace doing mad work.
I think Resolution's on tilt. He was on literally just his high ground hill, and he TP's out in front of Invoker. I think he was TP'ing one of the other lanes, try and help. But There's no way that works, right? There's up, this tornado. He ends up dying in the end because the spirit breaker charge giving vision, but can't see why he would try and TP her. Like, when you know this invoker can cancel it.
Okay, I have to say something. I feel like Supreme, both games, maybe we haven't given him the credit he deserves because Empire did end up winning last game. He's really good at this hero, clearly. I mean, he's not meant to win a lane against a Quap. I know there were a lot of other heroes there. There were a lot of compounding factors, and they're going to go on Aloha Dance. They've got the EMP. They decide not to go for it, realizing that Wyvern's there. But he's doing really well, even when it came down to stuff like simply the CS. He was doing much better than Quap in lane, even when there weren't other people around. So he knows how to play Dota, or at least Invoker.
Really good player. But as much as I agree, he's playing in the situations well. I feel like one Resolution should never die last game solo to him, and this game Resolution's just making some really questionable decisions. Feels like now he's like scared of going out into the lane. He's a level 6 Quap at 12 minutes. He's going into the jungle to farm with level 2 Scream. Bad this is. Like, the Night Stalker is higher level, higher net worth than him. The Tusk is higher level, higher net worth.
We can take a look over the levels, and while the Quap is certainly being... she is taking a severe beating when it comes to experience, the Phantom Lancer is the same level as the Invoker, and of course the supports on Empire are doing much better than the supports on Alternate when it comes to levels. They end up going for a big ol' smoke on Alternate, and this, I believe... yeah, they have one more in stock. For the lineup of Empire, I think they have two more in stock. They're gonna go for the PL. Now, he is hard to lock down, but good news for them. Never mind, bad news, he's TP'd out. And it's nighttime, so they didn't quite see him there.
That's so unfortunate for ATN. And on the flip side, it's really fortunate for Empire, Radiant's because it's gonna waste a lot of time. It's gonna give Resolution time to catch up even more, get a lot of damage on this tower. And they got one or two deep wards out. So, they're gonna have a bit more control of the Radiant Woods.
So, Exotic Deer, picking up, or working towards the Helm of the Dominator, pretty common item pickup. We have a gank attempt on Quap, if Invoker can force him to blink backwards, but no, here comes the Bane, isn't able to get anything off, and if Bane has Fiend's Grip there... he slept himself.
Yeah.
Oh, we've got a lot of action going on. That's the Winter's Curse Exotic Deer taking a lot of damage from allies. Where was the Splinter Boss? There was no more mana coming out of Wyvern. Cooldown completely whiffs, but that'll be that. And actually, we've got a Hunter in the Night going for Exotic Deer. No such luck. What is going on? I hear people being asleep, but there is no follow-up. They actually go for the stun, the Nether Strike, but he's going to double to the high ground, and now Robert is in a really bad spot. Quap is on the backline, Supreme taking a lot of damage. No points in Crippling Fear yet, though, for the Night Stalker. That's a 5-second silence at nighttime. He may take a tumble here. They should have the auto-attack damage with the amp, and now he's blocked off by his own Tusk. Quap is coming in, wants to use the Sonic Wave somewhere, but no cigar, and the Tornado EMP, she manages to jump out. Not quite the right timing's coming out from Supreme. Another Ice Shards, but again, only blocking out Exotic Deer, and I don't think they continue to chase this for the lineup of Alternate. Really weird engagement from both teams. I think some mistakes coming out there, or incorrect guesses on where heroes would be. I say as Quap goes in for the kill on Nisha, she could drop the Sonic Wave here, deciding not to.
Speaking of the Quap and the Sonic Wave, like, he was just on the edge of the fight the entire time, looking for the perfect chance, and never found it. So he opted to try and like right click, and then he nearly died for it.
Yeah.
This is not the Resolution playing amazingly when Empire were on top of their game.
I feel like it also really could be, I mean, they had a series before this. You mentioned that you don't think they get as fatigued, but I don't know how long of a day they've had, right? They're with the saturation in Dota right now, there are definitely days where it feels like their team's playing 8 games in one day, and even that has to bring it to, you know, being on top of your game. So maybe Resolution is just like, you know, lying back saying to his team, carry me. And that happens sometimes, so. Now, Nightstalker... yeah, I have to really disagree with this build. We already talked about it a little bit. 1 point in Crippling Fear, that's a 5-second silence. You're up against an Invoker, who of course predominantly relies on his spells. He's Invoker, enough said. And Gyrocopter, who has no damage output other than magic until he gets, you know, more items. He's nowhere near the point where he's right-clicking you for significant amounts of damage. So I think it's a bit questionable not to have that Crippling Fear, even just 1 point.
I can almost understand it, because you had a really good start. You're getting a amount of farm and levels in comparison to what you normally would. So, alright, I'm just going to try and hit as hard as I can.
Okay, funny story. The charge was onto the doppelganger, actually, and now Silent, he is a doppelganger expired, so they managed to get it onto the real one. Now they have the amp damage on the real one, Fiend's Grip on the real one, Silence! It's a little bit dead, to say the least, but I just thought it was really funny how the charge transferred to the only available unit around, which was the real Doppelman. Wow! Okay, so Supreme is as good as Miracle. You heard it here first.
Quite 8,000 MMR, but...
You don't know that, have you checked?
Yeah, he's... 8 or something.
Okay, well, we'll discuss how you...
Just people's profiles in the lobby, like,
oh gosh,
well,
I just don't do
fighting.
That. Oh, I was eating soup. Anyway, we have got a Yules coming out for the Queen of Pain. I guess just to make sure she can reliably avoid the EMP or the tornado if she's in its wake and doesn't have blink on cooldown.
Way to stop the Spirit Breaker charge, gives you a way to stop the Sada running at you, gives you a way away from you. It's a really good item on Quaff.
Yeah.
Dyer's middle Does it feel that good attack. In the games when you're behind?
Yeah, and it definitely can. If it saves her life a few times and helps her stop bleeding, I guess is the right way to say this, or we've got a stun coming out, but the Wyvern in a bit of a weird angle, and I don't know if they should go for this. The cooldown! Oh, okay. It's a vision-giving cooldown. I think that they assumed maybe the Wyvern's Arctic Bone ended up there, so they were going for the kill. And if it latched, it would have been a great play. Now they're going on Silent again, but this is under a Tier 2 where a Tier 3 still active. There's going to be a lot of support coming in. The immediate Winter's Curse, and Robert, he is going down. Finally, the Sonic we've been waiting for, but there's a huge EMP. No mana on a lot of these heroes. Enough for a doppelganger, but that was about it. Mech does come out of flow, but he should be out of the rest of his mana and Supreme. Now, trying to get out, Gyrocopter just falls to the siege of the auto attacks, and a really big dive not paying off for alternate.
Yeah, just a tiny bit too deep, giving Pyro a chance to come back in this game a bit. Despite like the Freeman Tornado EMP deafening, there was no follow up damage because cooldown was did earlier.
So we're gonna have Bane with a haste dropping red and black on the ground. It's really strange. Fiend's Grip immediately onto Silent. They should be able to get the EMP off. There's the Cold Embrace, but that won't stop his mana from being drained. This does mean he doesn't have a nice way out of it. He does have 4 wand charges. He pops them, uses the doppelganger away, and that should be the end of the engagement. But oh, Robert's thinking about going back in. I don't think this is the right play. He finally cancels after hitting the illusions. And that will be that.
Fiend's Grip to save the tier 1 tower though is definitely worth it.
This is a really even game, that's all I was gonna say.
Yeah, really surprised how little the Jaro's been able to keep his arm up despite the amount that was happening early.
I feel like he's died in a few inopportune places. I'm not paying attention right now because No Fear is maybe tanking the gank, although again, they are super deep on alternate in places where maybe they shouldn't be, and I do believe that ward was spotted out. Gyrocopter, he's 1-3, so keeping up his farm, not the easiest road in this case.
But it just feels like he's got the Ancient Specs rolling right now. He's got the creep doing that, so he's got some Dyer's kind of. But his team definitely have the ability to face for him, so I don't think he'll stay like where he was on the network for long. Now he's got the tower last hit as well, he jumped back up a bit. So suddenly it's not looking so bad, and he has an overclub flying out some. Might be the early SNY.
Yeah, calling out some big items because we've had a bit of that going on and actually seeing if we have anything bigger. Bane, of course, just Arcanes. Invoker this time deciding to go for the Yules. I guess to get rid of the crippling fear when it does come out. It's always a nice pickup there. We have an engagement. We're gonna have a Fiend's Grip and another strike, but they immediately drop the Winter's Curse. The cooldown is hitting on all of them, but Bane is wiped off of the map before we can even see, and the mech coming out. They're feeling in control to siege this tower, which hasn't been denied. Could have been denied, unfortunately. They probably felt like they were zoned with all of these heroes coming in for the Dire, and they are looking for more exotic deer again, maybe in a bad spot. I think we'll get away here. So, has finished up the Helm of the Dominant, now probably working on the straight BKB. Invoker has Yules, as we talked about, isn't able to be as an aggressive a hero as he was last time. And just the Urn for Robert, and of course the Blink for Nisha. Oh. Radiant's
middle tower is going to be able to secure the bottom tier 1 though, so at least it's a power trade. Unless they go in now, they're gonna regret this if they do.
Oh gosh, and the Dust Supreme, two more auto attacks should do it. Goodbye, Supreme, delaying the inevitable, maybe buying the TP out for Robert. So while, you know, not the sacrifice you necessarily want to make, but better than both of you going down because you were so easy to kill. And this is gonna help out Quap still below the Night Stalker, but she's getting there.
Not necessarily a bad thing. But since he got his axe, he's gonna stop farming, and then there's gonna be more space for the Quap. The earlier you get the axe, the more confident you'll feel in this game.
Yeah. I also feel like Night Stalker here is playing really well. He's now got some... I mean, he's level 11. He's got a huge toolkit and Phantom Lancer. All the space in the world is being made for him. He has 147 CS at 21 minutes. He does have two deaths. Silent has been recovering well from this, and he is by far the top net farmer. So,
considering the amount that's been happening in this game, he's done pretty well. Despite being somewhat involved, and on top of that, getting off this farm. Most importantly, not dying that much.
Yeah.
The one time he died in the woods was just unfortunate. Like, everyone was there, as you say, the charge got redirected and he kind of got...
Mm-hmm. Now, they just used Winter's Curse on Supreme down bottom. I think Wyvern and Nightstalker might have been ready to go, and the rest of the team said, hey, let's not go on this one, let's leave it. It is a big cooldown, and of course they know on Alternate, so maybe they can make something happen around this being down, because the last few times Alternate has tried to engage into Empire, it does feel like they've been eating Winter's Curses or other things, and just, you know, or a snowball dodge, stopping the entirety of the aggression.
Winter has mech and the snowball. It's always harder to fight into them. A lot of the damage from ATN is spread. There's no single type of burst outside of just slaughter damage and right clicks.
Now, speaking of slaughter, Sonic Wave to the face. He's going to use his one charge, manages to get the stun off, but here comes the Phantom Lancer. Lance to the face, but the charge is coming out. They use the Fiend's Grip, knowing that Phantom Lancer doesn't have a way to stop them. And also, there's going to be the Bash as he charges on through. They manage to get one kill. Can they find themselves some more? The real Phantom Lancer, they know which one it is, but now he doppels away. It's getting rough, but they guessed correctly. And now Supreme staying on the back lines. He is silenced up, but auto attack should do this. Silent, they need like one more. No, it's not going to be enough. The rocket should get it, but the flat cannon is what, in fact, ends his siege. And now, Phase Boots, plus it being nighttime, means Nightstalker's gonna get away just fine. That was a really big turnaround for Alternate. And did the Wyvern die in that fight too?
Yes.
Okay, I missed that part of it because I was watching the Quap and the Phantom Lancer getting caught. But a 2.5k plus gold swing in favor of Alternate, they have to be happy with this considering where the state of the game had been.
It feels like whichever team initiates is the team coming out on the worst fight. At least for the past few engagements.
I will agree with that, and I think it makes a lot of sense with the abilities these heroes have. Abilities like Winter's Curse and Snowball can obviously reset fights, and then of course you have Tornado or Cooldown or a charge through there, which the Spirit Breaker managed to pull off, which just really destroy any synergy you were trying to build up.
And I feel like most of the reason for that is just either side have a lot of single target burst. Pop has good amount of damage, but it's all AoE. It's not like pure single target, so it's not the highest amount. Generally, Tengru, at least her spells, the follow-up isn't necessarily always there because we'll always blink in and the rest of the team isn't as mobile.
The Spirit Break is making a Blade Mail. I don't think this is a bad choice because, of course, you can always see when Quap's going to be using Fiend's... Oh, not able to get the Fiend's Grip off. When Quap's going to be using Sonic Wave, you generally have a pretty good idea because you see the wind-up and she can't exactly stop it. Although Supreme, he's going in onto Stand and Flow and they will Fiend's Grip the Snowballer. They get the kill there. They have the charge through. Winter's Curse on the back line. L, he's taking a lot of damage, but he doesn't quite go down, and now maybe they can return and fight. But Robert, he is in the middle of nowhere taking a lot of damage. It is support for support. Well, support for offlaner, although it's looking like Aloha Dance is bigger, and the BKB is dropped by Exotic Deer. They need to fight or get out of here. Supreme and Exotic Deer still staying on the high ground. I think that this team fight's going to be suddenly won by Empire with no BKB, Exotic Deer in a lot of trouble, and instead it's Supreme. Exotic Deer, I think, should just let him die. They're going to manage to, dodges a lot of that with the Yules, but Sonic Wave coming through, and Exotic Deer should fall before the TP of Yules just in case.
Okay, that TP made no sense at all, and that BKB, like, it was probably a panic thing in general, because you go up the hill, you see a load of PL illusions, like, okay, they want to fight us with upper illusions, you'll pop BKB, fend them off, etc. But as soon as that doesn't work, they need to run, and they were kind of hesitating. And then when they did kind of disengage, and Empire were just like on the outskirts trying to maybe find a pickoff, Invoker decides, okay, I'll TP away and try and farm a lane. That's not gonna work.
Yeah, and this charge, I don't think he's gonna let it latch, because it could just be insta-death. Oh, he's going for it. He bumps into No Fear, but has a lot of support. Actually cancels the Nether Strike, realizing they're not close enough by, because we have the TP out. No Fear should be able to Arctic Bone down to the low ground, but the Bash instead. They need a few more auto attacks. He is on the low ground, and with the Nightmare, do they have enough time to walk around for it? Beautiful Sunstrike. There's this taking a really long time for the kill, though. Tusk may come in and just save his ally. They have some more urn charges. He puts him in the snowball, and with the mech coming out, Robert not able to seal the deal. Splinter Blast, Robert may just fall here. He's using the defensive urn, but here comes Quap, and she is going to scream when he comes down from that Yule. This team fight has gone all over the place. There's now a Fiend's Grip onto the Quap. Walrus Man doesn't have the Walrus Punch, but the Quap doesn't go down. Bane's going to fall to the auto attacks from Winter's Curse, and now Supreme, he is standing in the middle of all of this business. They stop the TP in from the PL by killing all of the creeps, but he is, oh gosh, he's not nearby. Quap is on the outskirts now. Exotic Veer trying to kill them through the Cold Embrace, finally gets two kills there. Quap is on the high ground though, and they're turning it around. It's exactly what you said. If you initiate, well, I guess kind of the Spirit Breaker initiated there, but that team fight was a mess, a hot mess.
It's not very often you see supports like fighting for that long and getting away with it, but at the end of the day, didn't come out big though. 1.8k, or 2k technically, I guess.
And also, we've got Slaughter. He's picked up a Midas. I think he's going for a Lotus Orb, which is always really great against this set of spells coming out from Empire. He's also got a Gem and a Midas, so suddenly Alternate probably having a bit better map vision if they ever manage to catch this. We've also got them giving it a go onto the Phantom Lancer, but Robert taking a lot of damage from that Diffusal Blade. They know which one is the real Silent now, but they shouldn't have Fiend's Grip on cooldown since they used it in the last team fight. A Nightmare keeping Supreme alive and the Yules now to help him out. There's going to be the cooldown, the immediate Doppelganger. Can he kill Supreme first? Yes, he can, but he'll pay with this for his life. Arguably worth it. They're both really high net worth heroes, but I think getting the kill on the Phantom Lancer a little bit bigger for Alternate.
Yeah, it's definitely worthwhile, because what Silent's doing this game is he's constantly pushing in lanes, and on top of being worth more, when he's off the map for a long time, you actually get back. In fact, they've got a nice stock gem, so they did have a gem.
No, the gem is on Slaughter, and yeah, the gem is now on Slaughter. Or it's in the base.
Never mind about the gem, but the axe is still like a lot of control. Phantom Lance isn't there pushing in lanes. It gives you more mobility around the map, because you're not having to constantly push out lanes, defend towers. So you can make your own decisions around the map by being silent.
I'm a little surprised they didn't do a walkabout to like check for wards in their jungle with the gem, but it's going to end up being okay as the ward inside of the jungle expires. Gyrocopter has picked up the Yasha, going for the Sand and Yasha now. A bit late, but we've already discussed poor Gyro's farm. And Midas now, late one on Invoker. I believe he went that after the Yules, or I'm crazy. Either one could be true. So, low.
After the plate mail, like, haven't been keeping track of his items, so I feel like really bad idea.
I think they've decided they have to go late if they're gonna survive at all. Quap has finished up her Aghanim Scepter. Who is leading this charge? It's Robert. Who else was I expecting? We're gonna see Aloha Dance. They're trying to go in on them, but instead there's gonna be the cooldown. It managed to pick up one. The Winter's Curse expended on Robert. He didn't really stop too much, and Robert somehow is still alive. He finally burns out of the own charges, and Quap coming in. But if they can catch out Weapon Y, Aloha Dance as well, they've got him. But here comes the PL. He's gonna drain everyone's mana if you let him. The Self Nightmare trying to save L, and Supreme is here. Does he have some sort of wave clear to make it so that Silent isn't such a pain in their backside? He's taken out the Bane. There's gonna be the Tornado, but he should have another Doppelganger off cooldown for this. Can he fight them one against the world? He's taking huge amounts of damage, and they have him with the amp damage on the right hero. They have taken out Silent. They have gotten a 4-for-2. Hugely favorable trade for Alternate, and we are right back in the thick of things. This game, just like the first one, pretty back and forth. I like it.
Yeah, and I think Empire just fell on the same pace there, because they dropped so many spells on this Spirit Breaker who was running in at them. They easily have disengaged after the Yules, but they're like, alright, no, we'll turn around. They drop Quap ulti, they drop Winter's Curse, they drop Crippling Fear on him, and he tanks it all and lives through it, I think. Did he live through it?
He lived through it, and then the Qualp had to blink past them and use her spells on him.
He lived for a lot,
and he really took advantage of doing what we talked about, using blade mail to make sure he was using blade mail on damage that was unstoppable. Like, you know, you're taking damage. He used the blade mail when the scream came out and so on. So, always nice.
Yeah, but it just handled that spells, man. The rest of ATN had complete control of the fight. Like, Slada didn't have much to worry about. Jara's BKB is completely uncountered when there's no Winter's Curse. So, they shouldn't be doing that again. Getting out here.
Yeah, and it's really surprising. Oh, okay. Supreme just... Yeah, I think he's just deciding he really wants to make sure he can keep accelerating that farm and keeping it up even, because sometimes you just have trouble farming. It's similar to heroes like Zeus. You're meant to farm hero kills, but maybe they're getting a bit thin on the ground just because of how the game is going. Even though it's about 1.5 kills per minute in this game, I lied, 1.33 recurring. Hello, Robert, says aloha. You can see him completely and giving you dire vision, but at the same time, they found resolution again. They have amp damage, they have everything on him. Tornado gonna be... her death as she falls to the ground, wings doing strange things because she is a bat woman. Either way, Exotic Deer has no mana now. He does have an Aegis, but no mana. You're gonna have to die to get that back. This is only a minute left on the Aegis, so I actually recommend dying here. It's not often I get to say that, but Exotic Deer, my path of action I would suggest is death.
They should earn him up here, which they do, and then they're going to try and commit as much as the Stitter as they can.
They have to be...
hard to get it.
Yeah, they have to be a little bit careful with the timing here. Slithering Crush coming out, showing that creep wave, who's boss. Probably just a little bit short on the blink, trying to see if he could catch anyone out. And it's a nice attempt. If they did catch someone out, they could probably get a pretty big kill. But L may just take a tumble here. Tried to place the aggressive ward, does manage to glimmer cape himself up. And now they're going to be going on weapon. Aloha Dance onto the tower. Nether Strike, he's so dead. And now the flat cannon is actually starting to hurt them. We may be going to a game three, but here comes Silent. Seeing what he can do, Tornado, meaning that people are going to be taking this cooldown. Silent is taking one, he takes two, but they manage to pick off L on the Bane. Can they kill off Flo and Silent in time? They do, they get both of them. Quap is the only one alive. Immediate buyback coming out of the Tusk. We have gems on the deck. I think Quap got it back. The Slithering Crush completely off the mark. No one has mana, and Exotic Deer has no more Aegis, so this is going to be him going down. Pops the BKB, but Walrus Punch goes through that. Doesn't go for the Walrus Punch, though. There it is, coming out onto Slaughter. He should be able to... oh no, his sprint's on cooldown. He blinks away. Now he should be able to go for the sprint with the Sigil no longer chasing him, and that should be that, but they have reacquired the gem on the side of Empire. I don't know where it's gone, actually. Oh gosh, Slaughter, run away! Run away, Slaughter! Oh, this is what I've always wanted to see. He should be able to blink away from this, and he does. There's also going to be a Tornado saving his life. Really well played from the Slaughter. Exciting first usage of that Lotus Orb.
Calculated, boys.
Oh, that was beautiful. So, where did the gem... okay,
ATN
he's...
got it back. Jaro probably base.
Well, okay, someone just pinged it. Bane got it?
Bane picked
it up. How did Bane get it?
Jaro got it in the fight and then he got away. Probably dropped it.
Okay, yeah.
Now the Bane has it.
Excellent, so.
I'm actually really surprised they're able to take the fights like that.
So.
The big thing there though was they jumped one target and the Slider was able to find the Wyvern in the back before first off, which saved the target that they were initiating on. I can't remember who it was. A Nightstalker, but if they got that Winter's Curse off, it would probably be on 3 or 4 heroes, and then Empire could have turned the fight around. But the Slider just made big plays.
Yeah, suddenly Alternate 7,500 gold ahead, but we saw this last game. Alternate was ahead, and Empire just outplayed them in a few team fights. Now, let's do a quick item roundup because we have had a huge influx of gold for at least one of these teams. Of course, Bane, as we talked about, he is being a dewarding. Demon. Is Bane a demon?
An elemental.
Excellent. So, a dewarding elemental. We've got Invoker finished up that AC. This is, he had an Orchid last time instead of Yules, but very similar build that he went to last time. It's great here with the Slaughter as well. There's some nice minus armor synergy there, and of course attack speed. I think he's going to need a sheep or something to deal with the PL.
Yeah, I felt the same last game, like, he just needed one or two lockdown items. Managed to get a sheep after this, which I don't think he'll go for just because how the build's kind of built up. I don't think you go AC and then transition back into a sheep unless you feel like you really...
Yeah, it's a bit... And I wouldn't be, I mean, it's not really an invoker item, but I wouldn't be opposed to a Shiva's on someone just for the PL wave clear help. But, oh gosh, Gyro, don't do it, Exotic Deer, you have so much to live for, he's gonna run into all of them, there's gonna be a Warrior's Punch, he's gonna actually pop his BKB, but they have so much that goes through that, and he's only gonna get off a smidgen of damage, and now L trying to TP away, but there was a snowball on you, he's actually Glimmer caped up, dodging a lot of the stuff, Tornado hits on quite a few of them, but L, I believe, gonna fall to his elemental death, and he goes down there, taking a good swing of gold for the lineup of Empire.
And on top of that, the Nightstalker's just gem of his own, so the map control's gonna swing back in favor of Empire, especially after these few kills.
Yeah, let's see if they can get the return kills. I don't know if they're gonna keep going. Goodness, Invoker hits like a truck with the amp damage. Two more auto attacks, he's missing uphill, but now he gets it onto Resolution, and with the, oh my goodness, Snowball back in from Flo, they're gonna have more than enough to lock him down. And you were saying after these few kills, but I don't know who's getting the kills. A Tornado to try and keep Silent out of it for as long as they can. Slithering crushes up in 1 second, he's gonna manage to use it, but they throw him up in the air at the same time. TP out immediately from Robert. Can Supreme just invis and get away? He drops. Oh gosh, it's on cooldown. There's not gonna be no Ghost Walk here. He needs to Midas something. He's trying to run as fast as he can. He is dusted up though, and there's gonna be no such luck there. Gotta run to this creep camp. You're gonna die. Gotta Midas the tiny bird, the wild wing.
Yeah, I agree. Definitely Midas is some.
Yeah. But that was a really rough spot, and I was impressed by how many kills they actually managed to get there. Yes, they lost the Invoker, but we have just discovered that AC plus amp damage, you hit like a truck.
Yeah, even without AC, like, Stardust's just such an enabler for heroes like this that hit quite that hard, and then you see amp damage, and suddenly they hit like K net worth carries. Heroes insane, right? Another PR might actually.
Oh goodness, we see PL taking a charge as well. The Nether Strike is on cooldown though, but he does have the mana for Doppelganger. He's trying to get up onto the high ground. Oh, and the third trees though, they need something that they can throw up there. Oh goodness, they managed to get it with Bane's Brain Sap coming off. They dropped a ward for it. I like that type of play. It's very cute. And now
huge
this
skill.
Roshan. Yeah, pure skill, as you said. I mean, you know, if it were actually pure skill, then Robert would have bashed twice. So he has finished his Blade Man, now working on his BKB. Kind of interesting here. I mean, it can knock off the silence, you take less damage from the crippling fear, you don't take the mana drain from the defusal, and you don't attack your allies in the Winter's Curse, so maybe that'll change things up. This ward is about to expire as well, and they don't have another one, so I'm really surprised they bothered to leave this super low health.
And they just want to play safe. They know the PL has no buyback. Okay, they might not know he doesn't have buyback, actually.
Oh, and whether they know he has buyback or not, a big Slithering Crush onto three. There's going to be a charge through all of them. Really well played. There's going to be a cooldown. No Fear is already out of this engagement. Actually had the ult. The snowball is going to delay the inevitable. Nightstalker goes down on the back lines, and Flo tries to use that nice little snowball blink away, but auto attack damage is going to do more than enough. I have no idea where we're pinging that the gem was dropped.
That was just a gem here. No one died with it. That was just a free gem.
Wait, where?
I'm gonna say before that happened, they just wanted to make sure they got a favorable engagement.
Okay.
Try to find all five of them in the. They could maybe have, like, blinked in, stole the Aegis, made something happen.
Yeah.
What ATN did, they backed off, played it safe, and then found the engagement. Empire gave them a too easily, but nevertheless, smart play by them, and now they're probably gonna be able to at least take a 3. Well, the PL's dead for 10 more seconds.
Yeah, at least a tier 3, maybe even with that alacrity a bit more, and they're gonna get the quap at this rate! Do they have the damage? Yes. Yes, they do. So I think they go for the melee here, yeah, and they're deciding to change their efforts onto that. Rex, of course, the range, less health, easier to take down, doesn't regen, but there's gonna be a Winter's Curse. L, you're gonna fall to your hard-hitting Invoker, but if they get the Rex here, I think that's worth it on the sidelines, though. Nisha having a lot of trouble, a Tornado saving his life a little bit, and it looks like they're gonna get the full set of Rex. Quap coming in on Resolution, trying to see what he can get here. Bane also has bought back. I'm not quite sure what the plan is for Bane to come back into the fight, but Exotic Deer is up there, standing there, using the BKB, even though this is only the first life. Is the Flag Cannon damage enough? It's not! Flag Cannon's already down. Nisha comes in, though, back with the three-man Slithering Crush again. Can this man crush less than three people? I think not. Oh, the Sunstrike, it's gonna do a little bit of damage, but I think Nisha will get the finish-up damage there. Resolution blinks into a Slithering Crush, so she's gonna take a lot, too. And that, I think, might be GG. That's it, we're going to a game 3. We're gonna have to make sure that we get another stream up, because the America's games are gonna start. But what an exciting set. Thank you so much for all watching. We had a blast, I would say. a game three coming out, because Alternate, if they can take the next one, they are in a good spot to actually be able to continue on in Starladder. So folks, we'll try to get you into that right quick. Once again, I've been Llama Down Under, joined by PQ. MZ is my co-host. We got Mac Dota up on stats. You got his name on the screen. And now, to do this properly with the Starladder overlay, you've been watching Starladder Season 13. Thank you all so much for watching.